What's up, guys? In today's video, I'm gonna share with you all my industry V2 mods and upgrades. I will be focusing on the problems I faced with the printer and how I resolved them one by one. Hopefully, it can help you when you have similar issues too. I will cover my mods upgrades in three versions, as it always is. You can find all the detailed information from the description. Let's start with the problems I see on the stock version. When I get an Industry V2, after the assembly and some adjustment, it can print very well. However, I was not happy with the four major issues here. Firstly, the print bed leveling. I had to manually level the bed a lot to get a good first layer adhesion. The second issue I noticed is the elephant foot issue. I tried to adjust the Z-axis, but I couldn't get rid of it. The third one is on a bolting tube. I printed some ABS parts using around 250 degrees Celsius. I saw a shrinkage at the end of the tube. The last one is on the base of the printer. It's not flat if I tighten all the screws. Even the tool posts are not perfectly perpendicular with the base. So my version 1 upgrades are mostly for resolving these problems. I firstly replaced the bed level springs with these yellow ones because the stock springs don't have enough tension for raising the print bed more. These yellow springs can hold it better too. BL Touch is a lifesaver to me. With a BL Touch, I don't have to check the first layer printing. I mostly press the print button and then walk away. To be able to walk with the ABS filament, I replaced the stock tube with the Cabricom tube. Its diameter is smaller than the stock one, so I assume it works more accurate as well. But for me, more importantly, it can walk with a temperature up to 260 degrees Celsius. Dual Z-axis upgrade is the ultimate solution for the elephant foot issue. It's a simple upgrade, but you need to remember to adjust your Z-motor voltage reference or your Z-motor will not get enough power. I've changed the voltage reference to 1.5 and it works great for me. I also use these Z-motor mounts to avoid the potential binding issue. By the way, you'd better get the official Creality Dura Z-axis kit, so that your second lead screw are the same as the first one. Some third-party kits may have different threads on their lead screw. The wobble base issue can be resolved by these corner brackets. Also, with these corner brackets, the two posts now can hold their position well. In this version, I also upgraded the extruder. The stock one works great for me though. You probably don't need to do this as you probably will try some direct drive solutions later. I also did some cosmetic upgrades in this version such as cable chain, covers for tension knob, V-snort, nuts, and so on. I'm not going to talk about the details as these are not functional mods, but I still put these details in the description in case you like them as well. I also tried different filament guides. I won't recommend you try any of them because none of them are really necessary. For filament sensors, I've never had the time to use them. For me, with a filament sensor installed, it adds extra friction all the time, just for handling a very rare case, which can be avoided by some simple calculation. I also don't like these fancy filament holders with screws. You will figure out the reason when you change your filament frequently. This is the one that works the best for me. Don't print the original design. It tends to get out of the mount and break easily. The modded version with a cover on the bearings makes it perfect. Okay, let's check out the print quality now. Have a look at those parts by yourself, and then let's jump onto the version 2. I'm pretty happy with my version 1 mod, as it works really well until one day I printed a long part. The top layers have some random shifts. After I did some investigation, I decided to remove the glass bed and go for a direct drive extruder. So I got this PEI sheet and pasted on the heat bed directly. In theory, without the heavy glass bed, it vibrates less, and it should resolve the top layer shifting issue. And it did. Surprisingly, I also found ABS sticks very well on this PEI sheet. So PEI sheet is gonna be your ultimate ABS print bed solution. In my mod version 2, I also printed this direct drive mounting plate. According to my experiment, it does not improve the print quality, but it does reduce the retraction down to 1mm from 6mm. I think it's worth it, even if it does not improve the print quality, as you pay almost nothing for it. I printed using PLA Plus. Had been working very well. I did not see any deformation after more than several days of printing. My version 3 mods are all about afterburner. My intention was mostly for aesthetic consideration. As you can see, my version 2 extruder looked like it was built from some random parts. There's no design at all. But later, I noticed the afterburner also extrudes more consistently. I see less blobs on the parts. But afterburner is not perfect. It does not work the best with PLA. If we print around 50mm per second, it works perfectly though. But if you push your speed up to 80mm per second, you will see some cooling issues. This is my journey with Industry V2 so far. I will probably stop tinkering it for a while and try my new Prusa printer. In the end, I put 3 Benchy boards printed from different versions. Can you really tell what the differences are? Share your thoughts. Thanks for watching and see you next one.